Master Kester. Master Kester Productions. Please subscribe, like the video, and subscribe. It's free. Okay, folks, as you might have saw in the intro, I hope you saw it, we're going to be making our own fishing rod, I Love Ideas. So, we already have fishing rods. Alright, I'll show you one. Okay, so we have a fishing rod right here. It's very good. I use it in a lot of the videos, rigged with a little split shot, and a circle hook so none of the fish get snagged. Got a little reel on there. 10-pound test line. It's a perfect little setup. However, fishing is easy for me, of course. So I need a better challenge. And why not a better challenge than building a fishing rod? It's easy. So first, what I'm going to do is get a tiny little knife, and I'm gonna get like a little palm frond because there's plenty of them around here. And that's gonna be a support for the rod. However, this is not a knife. This is a knife. Now, of course, I will be very careful. No one is going to get hurt in this video. I'm a trained professional. All right, so we have plenty of palm trees where I'm at. And we're just gonna look for a palm frond like this, something like this, that has like a strong backbone. Like you have a bunch of dead palm fronds. We're gonna try to get some nice ones. Like this one might be a good contender, possibly. Too small. Alright, we'll just use this one. The first one we found. It's got a good backbone. It's pretty much straight. I'll twist out all the kinks. And it'll work well. Now remember, folks, I'm not going to get hurt. For I am trained. And let's do it. So we're just going to cut off the end. It needs to be sharpened, but we'll just hack at it. Perfect clean cut. Now I'm just gonna like shave it off. Perfect. Now next, I'm going to take off all these little palm frond leaves. Alright, that was a mistake, but I think it'll work because the base is pretty strong, it's pretty long, and I need a new one. So, when I come back, I'm going to have all the steps completed except for this one. Alright folks, now I'm back at the same position with a new stick, and this one's looking much better. However, I'm going to cut off to like right here. Where it's at least a little strong and less, like, bendy. So we'll do that right now. Okay, we just did it. Remember, folks, I'm being very careful. And it seems good. Hopefully this doesn't break. Now we're going to make little slits. So the line can be pulled through.
All right, and we're gonna put like a little, you know, something that we can find over here on here. Just time lapse. Time-lapse is ended, and I just cut, you know, little slits in this so it would, you know, look nice. Well, not just look nice, but actually work. Like right here, here's one. Right here. And they're just all around here. There we are. And now, we are going to find stuff. So, we're going to look for... there's a bunch of mosquito fish. Alright, so we're going to look for like hooks or something. Oh, hi mosquito fish. Like in the sand or... oh, damn. A little tackle box. Well, I can already tell it's been sitting for a while. Those hooks be rusty. Sweet. Alright. So we have a tiny little tackle box. It's got a few, like, what looks like circle hooks. Got two little lures and a bobber and some sinkers and some rusty hooks. The only thing that kept it afloat was this bobber. All right, cool. Now, all right, yeah, these things are super rusted. Been sitting there for a few weeks, I'm sure. All right, so we got some big circle hooks in here, which we can use to hopefully just bend them around these little slits. And it'll be act like guides, so let's do it. All right, I'm gonna bend the circle hooks into place. Hashtag time lapse. Ugh. And let's do it. Okay, folks, that took way longer than it needed to be, but I have the guides in. It needs a guide right here, but I don't feel like putting it on. The guides are in. Slip them through. Put them right by those hooks. And now we just have to go find some fishing line. All right, now we're looking for fishing line. Found you. Now I'm just gonna ring it on and I'll show you the finished product. Now I'm going to guide it on with a sweet time lapse. Go. All right, now we are going to time lapse me putting the line on the thing. All right, time lapse, go. Folks, here's the finished product. Here it is. Here's it in action. It can support some tension. It's hooked up to this bobber. That's the end of the line. It's got some line. I used the split shot and the hook that I found in this tackle box. And now we're gonna go catch some bait. and catch a fish. Okay, folks, we have all of it laid out, all the line. We're gonna be using a bluegill for bait, and we'll cut back when we're in the water. Okay, folks, I don't know how well you can see me, so I'll just sit like this. I have the fishing rod right here. We're gonna slap on the bluegill, and I'm gonna time lapse it all the way until we have a fish on. Here we go. Alright, folks, oh. We still have it on. Uh-oh. Damn it, it keeps on spitting it. What is it? What's it? What's taking this stuff? Uh-oh. He just realized he's hooked. He's taking some line. I hope I'm in shot. He's fighting pretty good. You guys heard that? Look, guys. Oh my gosh, a peacock. No. Guys, folks, peacock bass, little rod, flipping money shot. That's probably gonna be the thumbnail. Alright, now, unfortunately, he did swallow the hook, so I'm gonna pause the camera, unhook him, and we're gonna catch another fish. Folks, that was fucking crazy. It was insane. I caught a fish with basically a palm frond with hooks as guides and a line, and I just hand reeled like a fly rod. But the thing is, I actually caught a flipping peacock bass with a homemade rod. You guys can do it too. Flipping epic. Like and subscribe. It's awesome. It's free. Next NES review thing coming up soon. It's gonna be epic. And we caught a fish with a homemade rod made out of a palm frond with hooks as line. Everything I found on the beach. Just saying, that's insane. Caught it with a bamboo stick right there.
I just got up and walked to the door and I saw it.